Hello everybody, welcome to my session on Introduction to Data Structures. Data structure in computer science is a particular way to store and organize data in a computer so that it can be accessed as well as modified efficiently. It's not only regarding the storage of data, but also the storing the relationships among them is very important, as well as the functions and operations that can be applied on the data also plays a major role. Now we find different data structures are suited to different types of applications. Often we find different data structures are suited for a particular application also. So which one to select? So that becomes a real task to find out which one is the efficient of all. Let me give you some examples in this regard. Say we want to store the details of all students in a class or department. So which data structure are we going to use? Number one. Second is, say we want to store the relationships in a family, or say the relationships among different employees or job responsibilities in an organization. So that is a totally different type of data structure we will be using in the second case. It's a tree which actually is responsible for storing hierarchical relationships. Let's talk about another example. Say we want to find out the distances and connectivity relationships between different cities in a country. So which data structure are we going to use? Okay, immediately graphs come to our mind. Okay, so where actually the cities will be the different vertices of the graph, and the connectivity between any pair of vertices will be represented by the presence of an edge, along with a distance, which will be actually represented by the weight of an edge. Let us go to the different types of data structures that are possible. So we can actually broadly classify data structure into two types. One is linear, another one is non-linear. So linear data structure, what do you mean by linear data structure? As the name indicates, in case of linear data structure, the different data elements are being stored one after the other, that is sequentially. So if we start from one point or one data element, we will always go and end at one point or one data element only. So all the data elements get traversed in a single run in case of linear data structures. Some examples are, say, arrays, linked lists, stacks, queues. Going to the second type of data structure, that is non-linear data structure, we find these are not arranged sequentially. So actually a data element in case of non-linear data structure can be connected to more than one element at a time. How are they connected? Definitely based on some relationship between them. So as we find that the different data elements in a non-linear data structure do not get traversed in a single run. Like we have already talked about trees, tree is one of the non-linear data structure, as well as graphs are also non-linear data structures. Now data structures are basically about how we can access a particular memory location from a computer. Generally, pointers are being used to access a particular memory location. What are pointers? Pointers are nothing but memory addresses which itself get stored in a particular memory location of the computer and definitely can be manipulated by the program. Now, we find array is a data structure which can be computed with the help of computations on different pointers. On the other hand, linked list is a data structure which itself stores the addresses of the different data elements within itself. Now, regarding implementations of different data structures, we find we can write different procedures as well as routines to access to implement different data structures which will actually create different instances of that particular structure. Now, if we go into a little bit details of the different data structures that we have already talked about, we find that arrays are sequential data structures, linear data structures, which are being, where the data elements are being stored one after the other in memory. Whereas linked list consists of nodes, which consists of a data element as well as the reference to the next node in sequence. Stack, what is stack? Stack consists of a number of data items stored one after the other, like a stack of plates we have. And queue term is very much, we are very much familiar with the queue term. We have a queue in front of where the registration fees are being paid, say where we are paying electricity bills. So in case of queues, we find that one who comes earlier gets processed earlier. So that is a queue. So basically stack is a LIFO structure, last in first out, whereas queue is a FIFO structure, first in first out. Going to trees and graphs, we find trees and graphs contain hierarchical relationships. So in case of tree is basically a cycle free graph where we do not find cycles, where there is one only single path between any two points, but in case of graphs we can have multiple paths in between two points. So with this, we find different types of applications in real life where different types of data structures can be actually applied. Whereas for a particular application, we find different data structures are equally suitable. So there lies a real job to find out which one is the most efficient of all.